Hello friends, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. In this video, we are going to talk about local storage. Have you ever heard of local storage? What is the use? We talk about that with a practical example in this video. So stick to me whilst we move on. But first of all, let's understand what local storage is. When you visit a C-sharp corner, Now, it has a definition for local storage. It reads, local storage is a property for accessing a storage object, which is used to store and retrieve the data from the user's browser. It is accessible only at client side and not at server side like a cookie. The data stored in local storage is accessible. So, what idea that you want to grab from this? With a local storage, we can use to store data. And also we can access data from the local storage in the client browser. So let's say you have a shopping cart, you have a shopping website whereby a user comes in there. Now, try to add products. Now, when the products have been added, you don't have to add a product that has been added to the database. No. It might be that the person won't buy. So in such case, why do you have to keep the data in the database while there's no purchase made? So what you can do here is, as soon as I add it, you can actually store it in the client browser as a local storage. So whenever the next time, whenever the person logs in, he or she knows the type or the product that he or he chose. Okay, so local storage is very important because you can access data, you can save data in there. We can also get the same data as well. As far as the client browser is concerned, you can store the data and access it over there. So let's have a look. We're going to have a practical example of this. You're going to set data to the local storage. You're going to also retrieve it. There are two ways to do it. The first one is by using a Java runtime. So we can use Java runtime object, or we can use a Blazored local storage. That is a library. Let's first go through with the runtime. Then we go through with the library and you choose the one which it is easy for you to implement. Okay, so let's get going. First of all, create a Blazor WebAssembly project. I have created mine already and it is here. So when I run this project, I have nothing in. So let's see, let me run this project again and let's see what I have in my project. So that's a new project. Now when you run it, you can see I have the default one that we all have when you run a project. Hello world, and we have contact counter and the fetch data. Now with the counter, I want to, as soon as I click me, I want to set this data or this value at the local storage. And also I want to access it. So set and access. Let's first talk about how to do that with JavaScript runtime. So in our code, let's locate the counter.cs or the counter.razor file under the client section, pages folder, counter.razor. So this is the code for the counter. Now this is what we want to do. So first of all, let's inject the runtime. So at inject, now IJSRuntime, then we give it a name as JS. So once we have this runtime, we can now set this. So how do you set data to the local storage? It's very simple. So we're going to say JS or this a void, so it's not going to return anything, just setting up a value. So you can say js dot, then we can use invoke, so invoke void async. Okay, just setting up a value and it's returning nothing, so we can make it at invoke void async. Then with this is what we're going to do. So let's first set this first. So let's first take out the void. Then let's say we want to return a string. No, we don't want to return a string. So invoke void async. Then we have to initialize local storage. So local storage dot sets item. Okay, now comma. So what's the name of the item that you want to set? We want to give it a name as count. And now which variable do you want to hold over there? So that's the current count. Now all of this is going to work for us. Let's save this. Let's see if it's going to refresh. Now we wait and click on this and see if it is set. So click this. All right, so you have here as one, we have a two. Right click on this and go to inspect. Now let's click on this and click on application. Now you have local storage over here and that storage, so click on that and let's see if we have the application set. So click me and you can see it is, we have almost 6 here, but on refresh here you have no local storage item here. So let's see what we can actually do. So we have js dot invoke async local storage dot set item. Then we have the name, we have the current count, that's the variable that you want to set. So when this button or this method is called. Okay, so the next thing to do here is let's try to, so local storage, let's pass in the string here. Now local storage dot set item count. Let's save this. And now let's wait for it to refresh. Then we'll try and see by using the JS runtime. So good. So you can see it is working here now. So you can see I have one here. If I click on it, you can see I have two. Now you can see I have eight. Now let's try to get the item. So in order to get the item, let's set this as async, then as task. We have a variable created here already, that is count. So let's say count is equal to, now let's use an await js dot get item. So js, we have to invoke async, and now the item in the form of string. So we have to set local storage dot get item. Then here we specify only the item name, and that is count. So that is a count, and that is all. Let's save this again, and now let's see. Let's wait for it to refresh. Then we see to get it. But for now, we have to have a variable to hold it. So that is a count. So let's copy this, and here we can actually pass in another one over here. Okay, so this is a count. So this is a count. So this is get count, and this is set count. Okay, let's save this, and now let's refresh application. And now let's see our set count and get count. We set the value, then we get it at the same time. So set count is zero. Now get count. So if I, let's first delete this. So delete. So nothing is here. Now if I click on click me, you can see count is equal to one. Now get count is one. Now get count is two, and count is equal to two. So this get count is getting it from the local storage. So that is the first way of using JavaScript runtime. Just inject the IJS runtime in .NET 7, and now you can actually get this to finish that. All right, so aside from that, there's also a way to set this. Now I'm going to, let me just comment this. Let's comment this, and now let's use the same local storage. So we need to install the local storage first. So in order to install that, click on Solution Explorer, dependencies, right click and go to manage NuGet packages. Now with the browse tab, make sure you install Blazor.LocalStorage. This by Chris Senti. Yeah, so install that. When we are done, can now close it and we go to the import.razor. Let's import it over here by using the at using, so you can talk of Blazor.LocalStorage. Now we are good to go. So now let's use it here. Now in order to use it, we have to inject it. So let's inject, that is IJSRuntime service. So IJSRuntime service, then we can talk of local storage. So this is an object. Now let's set this here. So how do we set this? It is also very simple. Okay, so in order to set this, you're going to use await keyword, then local storage dot set. So let's say await local storage dot, now set item as string. Okay, now with the set item as string, we want to set this. So the name is count and the object is current count. Now let's get the same thing. So in order to get it, we use count is equal to await local storage dot get item as string async. Then we just specify the item name as count. Let's save this. Save this. Let's wait for a refresh. Then we are going to clear that. So let's delete it. Now I set this and I get it. I set it and I get it. Okay. So let's see. Now, once you have this, you can see this no more working, but with the help of the local storage, it's working now. Now one thing that you shouldn't forget is to add register the local storage service in program.cs file. So program.cs file, and I have to add builder dot services dot add blazor local storage. So make sure you add this. It's very important to save it. And now in, let's clear the browser cookies. So let's clear history first. So let's clear history. History, then this one here. Clear browser data. Let's clear data here. Clear. Now let's refresh application. So it is now loading. And you can see from this side, nothing is over here. Let's click on it to set. So that is one. We have it here as 1, 2, 2, 3. And you can see we get it as well. All right, so that is it on how to set local storage, how to get a local storage value or data in a local storage. So if it is a login form that you are using, you can store the credentials and local storage from the client browser. If it is a shopping cart that you are creating, you can also do the same to the local storage as well. So it's very important, it's very essential in programming environment. So I believe this is clear. Alright, so this is code also going to be available at the GitHub, and I'll link the link over here under the description of this video. So you can just go in there and grab it as well. That is it for this video. Thank you for watching, friends, and hopefully I'm going to catch you up in the next video.